Your next deal is going to make you the highest paid writer in Hollywood.
Where do I sign?
Are you not, or have you ever been a member of the Communist Party?
Many questions can be answered yes or no only by a moron or a slave.
Tell me a little bit about the process of working with Trumbo's real daughters on this. Were you surprised by how much they wanted to be involved?
I hoped they would. In doing other films about real life people, I find you can get so much texture from their actual personal stories. The specific things are so telling when it comes to telling a big epic story. And I think had been surprised people hadn't told their father's story sooner. It had been told in little ways, their articles and things, and a big way, their brother, Chris Trumbo, who passed away before, had made a really beautiful play, and then it became a documentary. So anyway, they were moved, I think, in a way that someone cared enough to try to get it right. They were extremely helpful, sometimes very Trumbo-like in their opinionatedness, which I loved. I welcomed it because it made it better.
Was there ever any trouble with balancing the entertainment value of the film with the historical facts? Because what surprised me most about it was the tone. Mm-hmm, I felt it was very vibrant and human, and that gave me more access to the material than I thought I would have.
That means a lot to me because I actually think tone often comes from casting. And when you cast people who have the whole range of kind of the human experience at their fingertips, like John Goodman, who can be as serious, you know, as a serial killer, but it can also be very funny, very, as Frank King, he embodies this kind of rugged individualist producer who doesn't care about any of the studio system and just gonna make his movies at the lowest budget possible. He ends up being a hero because he enables Trumbo to write these blacklisted scripts and wins an Academy Award with Trumbo for a little tiny movie. So I think you establish tone with casting. Louis C.K. as a hardline, you know, left-wing communist guy who busts Trumbo for his hypocrisies. That says, okay, they're taking this seriously. This stuff really matters, because it did matter so much to me to get that right. But they're also acknowledging that there are absurdities in this story. There's a lady who wears crazy hats who's one of the most dangerous, you know, influential people in America. Helen Mirren's character, Hedda Hopper. There's going to be some absurdity in there somewhere.
And I love Louis C.K.'s line when he says to Trumbo that basically everything he says could be carved in stone somewhere.
Yeah.
Was there any line of dialogue from the movie or maybe a quote from him that really sticks with you?
I love that one. I like it when John Goodman says, "You don't want your name on your script?" And goes, "You don't want my name on it." And the other Stephen Root, as the other King brother, says, "But you're not still up to stuff, are you?" And he said, "Perpetually." And that scene, I really think, stands for a lot of what makes Trumbo great. He's a prankster. He's a rebel and a brilliant writer, but he's kind of a smartass.
Were there any fun details you learned about him or stories that you heard that you couldn't include in the film that you wish you had?
There's one detail which I wish we had time for, which isn't so much sort of entertaining one, but he worked in a bakery for 8 years at night. When you bake pastries for breakfast, you have to get up and go and work at 2 a.m. He would finish making, you know, the morning's pastries and then go home and write all day for 8 straight years, and was taking care of his ailing mother, his 2 sisters. They live in a tiny apartment above a garage in L.A. And then eventually he starts getting reader jobs and little mini screenwriting jobs and builds his career and writes Johnny Got His Gun. So I wish I had time to tell a little more of that sort of backstory, because it reminds you what an underdog he was from the get-go.
Fire Dalton Trumbo.
I don't think you and me are going to be pals.
Do you have to say everything like it's going to be chiseled into a rock?
Whisper a movie you've written in secret. Maybe I've even heard of it.
Maybe you have.